getting started with NASA's Visible Infrared Imaging Radiometer Suite, or VIIRS Surface Reflectance Data Part 2, Using the Data, presented by the Land Processes Distributed Active Archive Center, or LP DAAC. This is Part 2 of the Getting Started with NASA VIIRS Surface Reflectance Data video series. This video will cover what surface reflectance means, the types of VIIRS surface reflectance products distributed by the LP DAAC, the scale factor of the data and other data values, various VIIRS band combinations, and how to find VIIRS surface reflectance resources on the LP DAAC website. Surface reflectance can be described as the amount of light reflected by the surface of the Earth. VIIRS surface reflectance data are estimates of surface reflectance in each of the VIIRS reflective bands. Surface reflectance is a unitless ratio of surface radiance to surface irradiance, with a value that typically falls between 0 and 1. VIIRS surface reflectance products are distributed as hierarchical data format Earth Observing System 5 or HDF-EOS5 products. The file name contains the short name, VNP09. Here's a visual representation of the data stored within a single file for the VIIRS Daily Surface Reflectance Level 3 gridded product, VNP09GA. The file for this product contains information about the satellite, the sun angles, the surface reflectance bands, quality information, and information about the satellite observations. It is important to know that before you begin using the data, a scale factor must be applied to surface reflectance data values. For VIIRS surface reflectance products, a scale factor of 0.0001 should be applied to the surface reflectance bands, resulting in data values typically between 0 and 1. Data values that fall outside this range are considered fill values. To learn more about the specific scale factors, fill values, and valid ranges for the various surface reflectance product layers, please see the DOI landing pages on the LP DAAC's website at lpdaac.usgs.gov. Once you have an understanding of these values, you can work with and observe each of the science datasets. Stacking or compositing the surface reflectance bands combines the band wavelengths to emphasize different aspects of the Earth's surface. Specific bands are assigned to the red, green, and blue portions of the image. Today we will demonstrate three band combinations using the 1 kilometer layers of the VNP09GA product. Band stacking can be done in most types of geographic information system, GIS, software. The band combination M5, M4, M3 creates a true color image and is a representation of how the human eye would see the area. Here is a view of the northwestern United States using the M5, M4, M3 band combination. Vegetation is shown as green, the snow and clouds as white, and the barren areas are tan or brown. Another band combination is M3, M10, M11, which highlights snow and ice. Here's the same location shown using the M3, M10, M11 band combination. In this band combination, snow is shown as red, ice and clouds as light pink, clouds are white, water is shown as a dark red, vegetation is green, and deserts are a light blue-green color. A third band combination, M10, M7, M5, is used to show natural color. This band combination exaggerates natural colors, making it easier to differentiate between land features. In this image, vegetation is shown as bright shades of green, land as shades of brown, clouds and water are shown as shades of blue. For examples of how VIIRS surface reflectance products can be used in scientific applications, visit the LP DAAC website. The e-learning page has tutorials, presentations, and other product resources related to the VIIRS surface reflectance data. Stay tuned for future data in action and publications using VIIRS data. Thank you for watching our video. For more information on VIIRS surface reflectance data, please visit the LP DAAC website at lpdaac.usgs.gov.